is Elder-elect Minister Robervalt King Pierre here with my testimony. So, it was since the time I was born, and since the time I could probably say maybe my ABCs and walk, learning how to walk, I knew that I was born to preach. I was born to be a pastor. Like, I was for sure that God had called me, because it was just being bullied, being tortured, being made fun of. Like, I didn't fit in. I didn't even feel like I belonged in a lot of the circles that were around me. It wasn't up until that I got saved where, like, I started to quote scriptures. I started to, like, write sermons, and I realized how, you know, just gifted I was in just, you know, letting the Lord speak to me about what He wanted me to talk about around my friends, around my family members. And I just remember the Lord prophesying to me when I was a baby that I was going to go around the world to different nations to, like, you know, preach His word. And I was like, God, you're not going to use me. A boy like me, a man like me, to preach your word, I'm a loser. People told me I'm not going to be nothing. But God brought me back to a scripture that says, you are fearfully and wonderfully made. And God also said in Jeremiah 29:11, for I know the plans I have for you, thus says the Lord, plans to prosper you, and plans to just give you a hope in the future. And also in Jeremiah chapter 1, God said, like, I knew you before you was born in your mother's womb. So therefore, I'm like, wow, God, you really got a plan for that. If your scriptures tell me that, like, I'm going to be saved. So it wasn't up until the age of 12 where I started to write scriptures, and that was the lowest point in my life. I wanted to kill myself. I was so depressed, and I was like, you know, I'm done with this life. If I keep continue to get bullied, it's done. But, you know, God grabbed my heart, and He allowed me to be saved. I accepted Him as my Lord and Savior, and it wasn't up until 13 going to the age of 14 where I got baptized, and I emerged in water and came back up. Since then, I knew that God has destined for me to be great, destined for me to preach His word around the world. And all I could say is the Bible, like, just like Kobe, he was in the gym 24/7. All he had in his hand was the basketball. So to me, that analogy now brings it back to me, to the first century. All I knew was the Bible.
Let's go out there and reach the most of Christ.